the traveling like jousting team and all that, doing an all bard like troop. An entertaining troupe yeah. would be yeah. an awesome way to yeah. adventure.
Yeah. Right.
You know,
right.
going from big city to big city.
Right.
I think that
Mike, let's work this in.
I honestly think that the campaign that the most recent D&D campaign that we played that we're allegedly going to be getting back to in a few months, our Sea Princess campaign, I think would be ideal for everyone to play.
My character bards. For Shannon's first game, Zamfir, he was the master of the pan flute. I was playing a bard, and I did want to play him straight up. You know,
right Which now would be perfect.
Zamfir
would be perfect for your skin flute joke.
Yes,
I couldn't find that one. I found the other one.
All right, Shannon, what is it?
Good.
Oh God, she's got to unlock her phone.
Yeah. What do you call a party of bards in full plate?
What is it?
A heavy metal band.
Yes.
What? Oh, wow.
That, Shannon, is why we don't build things up, because they suck sometimes.
Oh, no. Duh.
That was the point, right?
Yeah, that's the point.
Shannon only tells bad jokes.
I love bad jokes.
I believe my exact words to her were, there is no cure for you.
Going back to, you know, a party of bards, or just, you know, a group of bards, in L5R, what are the bards? The entertainers.
Like yeah. geisha and
I was thinking more along the lines of
the ninjas.
Scorpion. Yeah, well, yes, the actors.
Sure.
The Chaucero actors are the assassins.
Yes.
And spies.
I mean, and you could incorporate that into a D&D group also. A group of bards who go into a town and put on a show, and really, they're a troop of assassins.
Well, it's a ruse to pull off some
exactly.
job.
Exactly.
Well, that's what I remember reading about bards in D&D years ago before I was ever gaming with you guys or even really had a game group.
It was a before time.
Well, yeah. I mean, the bard would set up in the town square.
I remember you talking about this. This would be fun.
And then the thieves would go around, you know, cutting purses and picking pockets.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. We've never done that.
Well, never, ever, ever done that.
Yeah, Bart could hypnotize a whole crowd.
You know why we wouldn't do that? Is because Mike could pull out his bullshit table.
Fucking table.
And you would
end up with a bunch of potatoes and half a cabbage.
Out of a wereboar's pocket.
Right. Yeah. And he'd kill you and take your
Mike, please explain what they're talking about.
What was that from?
An old Dragon Magazine article, which was dedicated to pickpocket.
Yeah. If you hate your players, use this table.
Mark, you shouldn't think of it that way.
It's all a role playing opportunity.
They were just trying to bring a little realism to D&D. Not everybody's carrying of gold.
Exactly.
Well, and that's the
most people are carrying a half head of cabbage.
I believe a good thief would not target a guy who looks like he's carrying around cabbage.
Either yes. that guy's got an immense schwanz or he's got a head of cabbage in his pants.
Is that a cucumber? Fuck.
That's not a cucumber.
That's my dick.
I think that cucumber's a little bit rotten.
Wow.
I think that, and getting, well, realism. And I think historically, a person who was an entertainer was probably the most popular person that would happen upon your village.
Oh,
I think
yeah.
if somebody that
like
could,
Matt Damon?
So yeah, exactly.
No,
what?
If someone that could tell stories, sing, dance, play instruments.
From the drudgery
exactly.
of existence.
And I think that's something that we forget about sometimes is, I mean, specifically, I guess, scalds in Viking culture.
Oh, yeah.
A scald would be the equivalent of a bard. A scald is the guy that everyone wants to gather around the longhouse and listen to this guy tell stories about the gods and about what the heroes did and things like that. I mean, those are the things that I think we need to concentrate on if we ever do play bards in the future is, you know, for the game master too and the players, is that that's how you got to look at that type of character. If you're playing that type of character as an entertainer, then that entertainer should be treated like an entertainer.
And protected and revered
exactly.
by his group.
Right. Well,
exactly. The best and vastly higher level than everyone else.
Yeah.
So you start right. out higher.
The best example I could think of a D&D style bard is Tom Marilyn from the Wheel of Time series. And he's exactly that. He is a guy who tells stories, recites the ballads and whatnot. And he plays either a flute or a harp, depending on what he's up to. He juggles. He does tumbling acts. And when he shows up at the beginning of the story, he's the biggest thing to happen to the town that year because right. they're living out in the sticks.
Oh, that's right. He's called the Glee Man.
Yes.
Because you have a Glee Man.
That sounds like a Shadowrunner archetype.
It does. A Glee Man entertains like the simple folk.
Right.
But then bards entertain the royalty.
Right. Mm-hmm. And Tom Marilyn, if you know the story, had been a bard of a royal house before shenanigans ensued. And
there's a lot of shenanigans in the Wheel of Time.
Well, yes.
Well, and as Bard should be getting into shenanigans.
Right.
Exactly. You know what I'm saying?
Are they cheeky and fun shenanigans?
He was also like a master spy. It's like he rolled up into a castle, and within a couple of weeks, he'd have all the maids working for him.
Right, and information gathering and things right. like that. When I think of a bard, especially with my history of reading a lot of Conan, I think of Rinaldo, the mad poet. In the very first Conan story ever written, it was Rinaldo, the mad poet, who incites these people to try and assassinate the king. You know, they could be troublemakers.
That's why Conan says, never trust a poet.
Never trust a poet, that's right. But
no truer words have ever been spoken.
That was Durden's job in the Epic campaign. I would come in, I would tell everybody that Baz Shalun was not a dangerous lich and was actually a really good guy.
So you were lying
just
asshole.
He wasn't a lich, he was just a man with a bad skin condition.
And his potions were suppositories, so no thank you.
Well, that was just...
That was flavor.
Yeah, that's right. That way you can take multiple potions at once.
Right.
One up and one down.
That's right.
Wow.
And Eric has problems.
Mm. Yes.
But that's okay.
It gives you a whole other magic item slot.
There you go.
Oh, that's what it is. Your ass is now a magic item
right.
slot.
Like, okay. Nipple rings, belly button ring, scrotum piercing.
No.
Jason wants to crawl out of this room right now.
Oh, no.
I cannot think of a place I would want a piercing less in the Middle Ages than my nutsack.
Right. Or any piercing at all, really.
Or any time. It doesn't just have to be the Middle Ages.
I was gonna go into that.
Like now.
You know.
As opposed to now.
Right through your Johnson.
How did we get to that?
Where? Magic item slots.
So guys, bards, all
right? Right.
So what other kind of bards are there? Bards, skalds. No, wait a minute. I thought of this a second ago. Shadowrun. Wasn't there something about Sasquatch?
Oh, the Sasquatch Entertainer?
You can be Sasquatch in Shadowrun?
No, you can't play a Sasquatch.
It was a first edition
I'm
archetype.
Be a hairy person.
It was a first edition Contact.
Contact, you're right, yes.
Yeah.
Contact,
okay.
Right. Yeah, and it was a Sasquatch Entertainer.
And he was like a lounge act, right?
If I remember right. Yes, picture was, he had like a fake
Star
air.
Wars.
That's right.
He had a fake air.
Had a Star Wars.
Yeah, that's why Mark's not going to play a bard.
Right.
Right.
Well, that's not why I'm going to play a singing bard.
That's why we're not going to let him play a bard.
I think we should do that and get that on mic.
Guys, I got a new song. Shut it.
Right. Yep. In a script Mark and I wrote, there was a bard character named Mustaine.
Yes,
of course. He was a bard, and he carried an axe.
Of course.
And he sung in really high falsetto.
Yes.
Was he drunk most of the time?
It was before. Jumping out of airplanes and shit.
Yes, right. Awesome.
I think we talked about clerics before in the past, and this is another case of, I think this, the bard class is one that, like you said, is just not given enough justice. It's not given enough respect by any means.
But I don't think it's not like the cleric in that no one wants to play it. I think it's more a matter of, I want to play it, but I'm not sure that everybody else would want me to.
I think that is a very us-centric point
of
view.
That's true.
Because we've had feedback, especially from the clerics episode, that there are people who love playing clerics and think that we are completely out in left field when it comes to people not wanting to do it.
Right.
So maybe there is people out there that really, really love playing bards and think that...
I would love to play a bard.
I was being serious. I want to play a bard. And yes. I'm really going to chronicle, and I'm going to make up stupid songs and sing them badly.
I know you probably won't believe this, but bard is probably one of my two or three favorite character classes to play. And it's just a matter of... that's how I feel. I'm not sure that that's something everybody else wants me to do.
So what we're saying is we just need to get all out of our system and do the all bard group.
Yes.
Is that after the all wizard group?
I think we should. I think what we should do is we talked about doing the zero level campaign.
Yeah.
Where we play the regular Joes.
The bards.
They start out at zero level, but they all become bards. That's how we should.
Garage band.
Garage band.
Green lightning.
Green lightning.
That's Shadowrun. We'll do that for Shadowrun again.
That's an actual play that should be recorded.
The thing about the bard is, and I've always felt this, is like with 3rd edition 3.5, it's one of the classes that's left over. If you're in a 5-man gaming group,
there's certain slots you got to fill.
Right. If you've got a game master and 5 players, you're going to have a fighter, mage, thief, cleric, and then, you know, bard is one of those leftover classes.
It's support.
And more than likely, that fifth guy is probably going to be another fighter.
Probably.
The job of all trades is the same reason why people don't like it, because they're not good at any one thing.
Right. Underpowered fighter.
None of the MMOs have a bard.
Yeah.
That's a good point. I never even thought about that.
Because buffing is its own.
Yeah, you do it yourself.
Yeah, you do it yourself.
Every class can buff itself.
I think now that we have 7 people in our group, it'll be interesting to see what the dynamic will be.
Oh, the next time we play D&D?
When we throw a group together.
You do.
Jason doesn't count himself.
Oh. No, I'm not counting the game master. I'm counting the players. Smart asses.
We need a huge band like Moody Blues or some shit.
The Eagles. There you go.
We'll make a ska band.
Right. Yeah.
Yes.
We'll have a whole horn section.
We'll do the Mighty Mighty Boss Tones, and Sean's the guy who dances.
Yeah.
Right.
Yes.
Perfect.
I just got a wagon with a brass pole on it.
I think if I worked on it.
Yes. Sean, that's brilliant.
Yes, Sean, I like the cart with the...
So our traveling entertainment group will be a traveling stripper group. This one was
a covered wagon. They just threw open the sides, and there I am spinning around in a brass pole.
That would be
Jason playing the skin flute.
You guys are all the strippers. And I'm just like your pimp or something.
Nobody wanted to see men strip.
I think you're confused about how strippers work. They don't have pimps.
That's right.
Oh, no. She knows exactly what she's talking about.
She would have fit in with Brian's old group on the boat.
Yes.
Oh, Brian would have hated this.
What, playing all bards?
Yeah, he'd have hated that.
Yeah.
He hate bards for some reason.
I think he had one bard character that I can think of.
Really?
But he played him like a swashbuckler. Totally didn't play.
Well,
him
you
like
could
a
play a bard like a swashbuckler.
Yeah, they had a.
I think he did the bard thing just for the macking aspect of being a bard.
Macking.
The charisma.
Brian worked that into all character classes.
That's true.
It was not exclusive to one class.
I'm a barbarian who can mack. Yeah.
Silver tongued bard.
Yeah. Bard's Tale, the original PC game.
As I recall, Bard's Tale, you were whatever class you were, but you were seeking, like a bard was giving information about the quest. And you were following the leads of... So I think that a bard could be a very good NPC to drive the plot forward.
Sure.
You know?
Like a Mr. Johnson.
Everybody, you have this bard that travels with you. And it's a good way to expound on information without making it just completely...
Quit giving him ideas.
What's the problem with that?
I already did that in the Sequences campaign.
Yeah, and we hated him. Because
that's
because
he couldn't do anything.
He didn't do anything, and he was the bell ringer of doom, if I remember correctly.
The Elven Piper who would tell stories. And
totally inappropriate stories.
Yeah, and then they'd happen.
Didn't we throw him overboard?
Nope.
He did not get hired on for another season, we'll say.
or is he one of the guys we left behind in port?
He did not get rehired on.
Right. Well,
we were like, cast off, quick, he's not back.
That's completely right. An ineffective or annoying plot device? No. But somebody who's actually like
useful,
actively helping the group, then that's completely different.
Right. In D&D, so you have tons of different gods, right? So there's a god of music and frivolity and all that kind of stuff. Are there priests, bards, or are they just priests?
My first character Eric ever ran for me was a priest of Olodumara, multi-class as a bard.
Nice.
So
nice.
Right.
Well, you know.
So you could do it. You could certainly do it that way.
Yeah.
And it makes sense. It totally makes sense.
I've always liked the idea, you know, like the god of thieves as priests would be thieves. You know, god of that just makes sense.
Yeah, that's the old Erebus Kale stories.
Yeah. So the same would be, you know, be for bards.
But I'm sure that's kind of how it works. I'm sure there's a requirement that you have some level of those kinds of abilities.
First edition bards had druid spells. Druid and wizard spells.
That's interesting.
Yeah, that was the weird thing about bards. They had some spells that were specific to them, and then some that were
a little bit here and there.
Because they could heal, but it was still considered an arcane casting.
I think in 4th edition it's arcane also, isn't it?
We'll have to play more bards and investigate.
Yes, let's. I like 100% the idea. More bards.
100% more bards. Actually, at this point in time, we need like 400% more bards.
If we do this, which it should be like, I'm going to get you, sucker. Have like one fighter and then the rest of us all play
so. Doing the theme song.
Music, right?
Yeah.
Every good hero should have some.
Yeah. Exactly right.
Perfect.
Right, oh, well. My God. This next campaign.
How buffed would that one guy be?
That would be a seriously buffed dude.
Do they stack?
No, because in 3.5, you've got like 3 different kinds of buffs.
It would just be.
It's 3-5. There's always a way around.
Yeah, exactly.
So, all right. I think we're going to wrap it up there, and we'll talk to you guys next week.
Bye.
Follow us on Twitter.
We are at Gamers Table.
Like us on Facebook.